Hello everyone, how are you all? Hope so you are all staying at home and fighting against virus COVID-19. Have you all spent most of the time in your home, but now the time is coming that you have to study also at home? As our Prime Minister have already said that the only preventions to COVID-19 is to stay at home. To the prevention of this, we all started to provide you the videos, lecture classes, and it is one of my initiative which is being made by me to provide you one of my lectures. As you already know that in the upcoming session, I am going to teach you the subject business studies in all your classes of class 12. Moving to the main focus content of the chapter, you have already studied what the business is all about, what are the factors that affect business, what are the type of businesses, what are the objective of businesses. But in the previous classes or in the previous sessions that you have already studied in your classes, the one major activity that you miss is management. That is how the management plays an important role for starting the business, or when the management is not being good, how the business comes to an end. The role of management or the effectiveness of management, you can analyze by your day by day activities itself. For instance, you all early wake up early in the morning, properly dress up and go to the school and reach at time. But the day you not wake up on time, you reach late in the school. It means there is some part of the management is missing, that is time. Moving apart, in an everyday life, whether it's a social activity or it's an organizational activity, no one in this universe is going to survive without focusing the management activities. Whether it's a profit organization, non-profit organization, or any other organization which is being engaged in any of the activities, has to study management. Now the question arises, what the management is? If I'm talking about in a layman term, anything which is being done to achieve a predetermined objective. Anything which is being done to determine a predetermined objective is management. And what you are going to predetermine, that is objective or goal. Therefore, the basis of management starts with the goal orientation. It means if you have to be manage anything, you first have to define your goals. It means without mentioning the goals, the management is useless or aimless. So the management starts with objective. If you clearly define the objective or in a direction you want to perform the task, your 50% of the work is being completed. And 50% of the work is being completed by the management itself. So, what is the management? It is an activity to organize anything, to achieve objective. Now, management has three concepts. Management has three concepts to fulfill the objective in a right direction. And these three concepts is a major activity for every organization to become the organization successful. They are, the first one is a process, second one is an effective, and third one is an efficiency. I repeat, the first one is a process, second one is an effective, and third one is an efficiency. Now, we are going to understand each and every concept step by step. Moving to the first one, that management as a process. Now, why it is a process? Because it has to contain or take set of interrelated steps. You never jump over activity. You have to perform several stages to reach a definite objective. So, as a process, management has set of steps. And what are the steps? They are planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling. I repeat, what are they are? Planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling. Now, as a whole, you see that they contains sets of processes. Each process has a hidden process, or you say a step called coordination. You never going to miss this step coordination because it is an overbridge activity. That is, it is the combination of all activities. I hope you are all getting the points. Now, moving to the second concept, that it is an effective. Now, how the management is effective? If we have been provided a target, we have been providing a target on time. It never means that your class teacher has given you the work to be completed on tomorrow and you are going to submit your work after 3 days. You are not effective. In the hope of management, management is effective only when you are going to complete the task on time. Therefore, the second concept of management is that every management must be effective. That is, effectiveness is that when you are going to complete the work on time. Now, moving to the third one, that is efficiency. Efficiency is in terms of minimization of cost or least wastage of resources. Efficiency means least wastage of resources or minimum cost. Both are very important for the development of management activities. To form the management, these three concepts has to be clearly kept in mind. That is, every management has to perform several set of processes with effective and efficiency. Therefore, if we say what are the three things that should be considered, they are process, effective, and efficiency. Now, hope so that you had already understand the concept of management. Now, moving to the third one, that is characteristics of management. Moving to the third one, that is characteristics of management. Now, moving to the characteristics of management, I have already explained you that every management starts with goal or objective. Every management starts with goal or objective. Now, to clarify my points, that the first characteristic of management is, management is a goal-oriented process. Why it is a goal-oriented process? You are going to first make some of your objectives. either in terms of economic, social or human. You are going to make objective either in terms of economic or social. On that parameters, you are going to judge whether the management is effective or not. Therefore, the first characteristic of management is a goal-oriented process. Now, when the management is a goal-oriented process, the starting of the chapters, when I'm opening the chapters, I have already told you that no organization in this world can survive without the existence of management. No organization in this world is going to survive without the existence of management. For this context, the second characteristics that comes in mind is management is pervasive. Now, what the pervasive is that in every organization, whether it's a profit organization, non-profit organization, or whatever it is, it has to perform the activities of management. It means no management can survive without the existence of management. No company can survive without the existence of management. Third comes, management is multi-dimensional. Now, why the management is multi-dimensional? It is multi-dimensional because it has to manage of work, manage of people and manage of operations. Manage of work, manage of people and manage of operation. It means on the same time, management have to perform multiple of activities at the same time. Fourth come, management is a group activity. It means a single person cannot perform all the activities. Therefore, the work has to be first divided and make a scenario that everyone comes together for the common objective. That is, management is a group activity. It means it is a stick which binds together. It is a stick which binds together each and everyone to comes together and perform the task for the accomplishment of objective. Next term, management is dynamic. Next feature is management is dynamic. Now, what the meaning of dynamic is? The meaning of dynamic is changeable. The activities which changes easily. Now, it is not just like a color that you mix it and it changes automatically. Though it is have colors, but a colors of environmental factors. These are the factors which the managers or the top head institutionals has to read it, analyze it, and the policies has to make according to the changes made in the environment. Therefore, why the management is dynamic? It is dynamic because management changes its role, changes activities, changes its policies from time to time. Likewise, its environment changes. So, what are the characteristics of management? They are, management is a goal-oriented process. Management is pervasive. Management is multi-dimensional. Management is group activity. Management is dynamic. Now, these are the five major characteristics of management that the CBSE board asks every year. But other than these characteristics of management, there are other characteristics too. For example, management is invisible or intangible. Management is invisible or intangible. Why it is being invisible or intangible? It is invisible or intangible in the sense that we are not going to see the activities of the management. We are not going to see the activities of the management, but we are going to analyze in terms of result. If the result is effective, we say that management is good and effective, but we cannot see the activities of management. We are only going to judge the management is to be effective or not in terms of result. Therefore, management is intangible or invisible. Next is, management is creative. Why the management is creative? To perform the task, every time we do several activities, several innovations from time to time to do the activity in a simple and easiest way. And these number of people comes together and give their views and ideas to the top managers, and the top managers combine all their ideas and brings new ideas which might be effective for the organization. Therefore, the next feature of management is creative. So, what are the features of management? They are goal-oriented process, first one. Second one is it's pervasive. Third is multi-dimension. Fourth is it is a group activity. Fifth is it is dynamic. And what are the other two ones? It is an intangible, and management is creative. Hope so. Till now, you are getting all the points clear. Now, moving to the next concept, objectives of management. We classify the objectives of management into three parts. They are organizational, social, and human. What are they? They are organizational, social, and human. Now, moving to the first one, organizational. Now, if I ask you the question that what can be the organizational objective? The organizational objective is being related to earning of profit. The organizational objective is being related to survival. The organizational objective is being related to growth. Any other thing? They might be, but these three are the basics one. What are they? Profit, survival, and growth. It means the basic objective of every organization or every institution is to earn profit. Because the successful of the organization or the establishment of any institution depends upon how much profit the organization is going to earn. Now, with the help of profit, the organization is going to survive. It never moves to growth. First, organization is going to survive. The profit the organization earned is spent in the organization, and these profits is going to survive in the organization. With the survive, the next goes to growth. Now, what the growth is all about? That expansion. That is from one institution to another institution, from one company to another companies, or with the hike of objectives, with the hikes of personal values. It can be several. Growth cannot be just on a single parameter. But as a whole, if you're talking about the organizational objectives, they are the three ones. What are the ones? Profit, survival, and growth. Moving to the second objective, that is social objective. Now, what the social objective is all about? Social objective is all about that society has to provide to the organization. An organization has to provide to the society itself. For example, you are providing good supply of goods. You are providing good quality of products. You are not being indulging in unfair trade practices. You are not exaggerating your profit limits. These are some social objectives that you kept in mind, because you have been taking the profit from the society, and the society in returns provide their income to the organization. So the organization has to specify it very clearly, the social objective. That is, it never going to cheat or unfair trade practices at any time. The third one is personal objective. Now, it is the major one. Why the employee joined the organization? For its salary. Why the workers joined the organization? For its wages. Or in future, you all students, you are going to join the organization to get a good salary. If your boss is not going to provide you a handsome or good salary or unfair wages, you are not going to perform the task at any time. You are only going to perform the task when your stomach is full with food. And the food is its salary or wages. Or not any unfair trade practices. Therefore, the human objective or personal objective is related to treatment of fair justice to the salary of workers, salaries, anything that the employees are getting in the organization must get on time and not be violated the rules made by the government. Hope so that you are all clear the objectives of management. They are three types: organizational, social and personal objectives. Now, moving to the next part of the first chapter, that is nature and significance of management. The next is nature of management. When we talking about the nature of management, we classify its nature into three different categories or classification. They are management as an science, management as an art, management as a profession. I repeat, they are being classified into three parts: management as an art, management as a science, management as a profession. We are going to study each and every one by one in our next video or in the next session. But before ending up my lecture, now we are going to repeat or classify my all the things that I have already told you to wind up this lecture. Now I'm going to repeat what the management is. Management is all about to organize all the activities or to come up with all the activities to come to finish the objective or to fulfill the objective. It means to be an effective management, there must be some objective. That is, without the objective, no organization is going to survive. Or the role of management is ineffective when there is no existence of objective. And to complete the objective, we require three aspects. And what are the three aspects? Process, effective and efficiency. As a process, it has sets of steps. And what are they? Planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. Planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. And what is the binding process? It is coordination. That is, we are going to study in our upcoming lectures. Now, moving to the characteristics of management. What are they? They are, management is a goal-oriented process. As a goal, whatever I told you, as a goal, it must have sets of economic or social objective. It means in which directions you have to accumulate your resources, in which directions you have to gather the resources, in which directions you have to focus the your strength. These are comes under goal orientation process. And what the second one? It is a pervasive. How it is a pervasive? It is pervasive. That is, it is being applied in each and every organization, whether it is a profit one or a non-profit organization. no organization in this world is going to survive without the presence of management. Third comes, management is multi-dimension. Why it is multi-dimension? It is multi-dimension in the sense it has to manage several activities, that is activities of work, activities of people, activities of group activities and many other things. It has to manage several activities at the same time. Next term, it is a group activity. Why it is a group activity? Because management do not work in isolation. It has to be, comes together, bind together, number of works together for the same objective. No single person can accomplish all the work at the same time without taking the help of others. And to complete the objective, what we have to do? We have combined all the activities of the management for the common goal. That is, management is a group activity. Next come, management is dynamic. Why it is being dynamic? Because management changes from time to time. It changes from time to time. And how it changes? It changes by reading the factors or environmental factors. In the upcoming chapters, I'm going to told you that what are the environmental factors, what are the manager's roles to analyze these environmental factors. But before going to these several chapters, just come in mind that dynamic are the nature of management. What they do, the factors which is been moving in the environment, and we are all say or they are the business factors, and they are both for the organization, for the its can opportunity and threat its well, and these are being first read out and changes. And what changes? They changes their policies, their role, their style of working in each and every one. So what the next one? Management is dynamic. Next come, management is creative. How it is creative? It performs activities from time to time in a different way. Every person have unique style of performing that. Everyone is performing the task for the benefit of the organization. God has created the human being by providing the thinking level different from person to person. And these are being utilized by the management for the accomplishment of objective. So, being the next feature is management is creative. What the managers do? They utilize the different brains of their subordinates to understand the environmental factors as well as for taking the decisions itself. And the next one is management is invisible. Why it is being invisible? Because we are going to analyze the result, but we cannot see the working of management. We are going to analyze the result but not going to see the working of the management. Hence it is called management is intangible. So I am sum up my this video with the first lesson of the or some of the topics of the nature and significance of management. Hope so you are being watching my videos and understanding the concept of management, and trying to make my more videos attractive for you all and understanding, so that you all students can easily understand the concept of management by studying at home. It's my request you all to stay at home, be safe, only come out from the house only when you need it very urgently. It's my hearty request you to all. So study well, see my video, have any problem, please free to ask. Thank you.